For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that VDO, which is a new, which is introduced in RCL 7.5 as a beta version, but in RCL 7.8, they have released the complete version over here. So the VDO, in the sense, Virtual Data Optimizer.
Like, share, comment, and subscribe.
So, which gives you more perfect for the applications like virtual machines and containers. Okay, are the object storage. So where this VDO can be used? So VDO can be used as a object storage, or maybe like virtual machine storage, or the container storage. So which gives you a lot of storage space savings, which using the thin provision and the deduplication option. So what are the data you write on this VDO, which will inline will do on a compression and the deduplication, so that which saves a lot of space over here. So this virtual disk optimizer is a virtual disk optimizer and thin provisioned storage. Next one is provide ultimate deduplication and compression for the storage space savings. The best utilization is for the cloud storage and container environments. Here there is a term called UDS. So this UDS will provide the indexing mechanism on the disk itself, the virtualization. So for the deduplication, so UDS is a kernel module which will write the deduplication index to that VDO and makes the deduplication perfect. So, and here, so we are going to install it and configure it. By default, the VDO configuration can be written on /etc/vdoconf.yml file. So it writes in a Ansible format. So whenever you execute this, it by default check the videos, all the stuff. So in order to install it and configure this one, so if you are configuring this VDO for virtual machines or the containers, you have to give the logical size for the VDO would be in a 1:10%. So if example say that if your disk is 20 GB in size, the logical size should be a 200 GB for the virtual machines or the containers. So, but if you are using for an object to storage, so that should, you should give 1:3. Example, if your disk size is 20 GB, then you have to give 60 GB as a logical size. So what is that logical size? While we are creating, you will see that. Okay. So in order to do that, first of all, you have to install this VDO and kmod-video. So these are the modules you have to install in this machine. Let's install this. Seems the package is already installed. Let's verify this system status. So status VDO.service. So the VDO service is running fine. So now you have to create the VDO. In order to do that, you need a black device. So example, say fdisk-l, if I go, or lsblk, you can go ahead and see that there is a two devices I have. So one is 10 GB and one is 20 GB. So I'm using this 20 GB disk to create a new device. So VDO create -- name. So what is the name you would like to give to that VDO? So I could say VDO 01, something like this. So VDO name is VDO 1, or maybe VDO test. something like this, iPhone, iPhone device, which device you would like to use this slash dv slash sdb is the device name. This one I'm going to use it over here. And video logical size equal to 200 GB, because I am using this SDB is an 20 GB, so that 1:10 ratio, so that's why I'm just using 200 GB. You can use maybe 500 GB, 750 GB, or 1 TB, anything. So logical size depends on your usage actually, okay, but this is perfect for me, so I just use that. So in order to create the file system on this device, so we have to use MKFS. You can use ext4 or XFS. So I'm just going to make the file system as XFS here. In order to format this, you have to use -k over here and the device name, so which makes the XFS file system here. Then you can simply mount that device. So in order to, before mounting, you have to intimate to the kernel saying that the partition table update says, okay, I have created this partition. So in order to do, udev adm settle is the command to update that partition table over here. And you can mount this device is to, maybe I can say media and ffnh. You can see which shows you 200 GB over here, which is not exactly the correct one, but this is the actual logical size over here. So if you want to see the actual size, you can use video stats -hu or human readable, sorry, -hu. You can see again -hu is the option where you can see that actual that video size. So here is the 20 GB and used is 4 GB, and you can say 20% and available is 16 GB, something like this. So here I have some data already in this, because I did not format it the device, that's why it says 4 GB is already exist on that device. So if you do a format so that it won't show you that 4 GB size over here. Okay, now let's copy some data and see how it works. Okay, so example, say this give you a most data saving on this device. Okay, example, which is saving 99% over here. If you copy a multiple data onto the same and start the FS stream, so which gives you a more deduplication saving space over here. So how it works, the deduplication size, example, say if you have this this one, I would like to copy the file to the slash media, okay, and I'm copying again mkdir slash media, and I say FS01 and FS02, FS03, like this, and I'm copying this to the multiple places, and I'm copying this one to the FS02, and I'm copying the same to the FS03. So you can see that slash media is the one video size, but here it says 1.1 GB is the used one and available is 199 and 1% is the used one. And if you go to the slash media and see, these are the files FS01, so all the files are there. Now video stats -hu, you can see this is says and 4.1 GB is used and available is 15.9 GB, usage is 20% and saving is 72%, right? But if you do a FS stream on this file system, which will give you the most space, FS stream and slash mount point, which takes a little time, and it will dedupe that data. So whatever the unused blocks will be discarded and will make more saving space over here. So that how it works. If you copy a multiple same data into the file system, which will make the deduplication savings, and if you run the FS stream and that makes all the deduplication data and save the space. Example, say if you copy a 1 GB data into that VDO file system and say 1 GB multiple time by 4 times or 5 times, then the usage of that file system would be only 1 GB, not 4 GB. That's the deduplication makes more saving on this VDO. But this stream may take longer time because it's the first time which is running on the mount point. Maybe if you want to run the same on a regular phase, so you can use something like service that is called as a systemctl enable the service, which is called fs stream dot timer. So this is the service you have to enable and start it, so that it will regularly discard the deleted blocks automatically. You don't need to do a manual fs streams all on the file system, something like this. Okay, you can see, maybe you can see this saving is 81%, something like this. You can run the fs stream manually, or you can use a regular discard process using that fs stream dot service timer service, which will automatically do your things over there. So if you want to start or stop the VDO volumes, you can also use VDO stop --name, and you have to give the your VDO name over here. VDO test is my VDO name. So it says cannot stop because the volume is already is in mounted. You can just simply give this unmount and try to stop it. The VDO is stopped. Now if you go to VDO stats --hu, you can see this, there is no VDO. So again, back, if you want to start that VDO, you can just use this start process, and you can see the data would be there and the VDO has been started. So in a similar way, you can activate the VDO, or you can deactivate the VDO. Sometimes if you want to migrate that disk from one server to another server, you can just deactivate. Example, say VDO deactivate and --name, and you can give the VDO name over here, so it will be deactivated. And you can see this, so that is deactivated, but you can see that status. So you can activate activating the VDO back. I can do this, or if you want to disable, or if you want to see this VDO status over here, which will give you a long list of details of this VDO, which will give total details what is going on inside and what is the writable policy sync and all the details, how much compression is going on, and what is the black device status, where it is status, all the details will be given over here. Okay, like this, if you want to disable the deduplication or disable the compression, enable the compression, you can do this using this VDO command. Example, say that enable deduplication --name VDO test. So this is the you can enable the deduplication, or if you want to disable that, you can also use the VDO disable deduplication, and you can give the VDO status over here, so which will disable the deduplication process. So that if you go back to the VDO stats, and you can see the space saving will not increase, it will keep on decreasing. The size will be used as much as like a normal disk partition. So this deduplication will give you the more effective way to copying the dedupe data. And if you want to compress the data, example, say that you have copied a lot of text files, it will compress and give you the more space, like the text files will be compressed more. So in order to do that, you can use enable compression --name equal to video test. So this will enable the compression. By default, the compression will be enabled. If you want to disable, you can simply say disable compression and the name video state, that will be disabled. So here, if you want to grow the logical size of the physical size of the video, example say logical size is 200 GB, if you want to change that to 250 GB, so you can simply say grow logical --name of the video and --video logical size. So while creating, also we have given this video logical size equal to 250 GB. Okay, now you can go to start and see that is 250 GB. It's going to be okay. I have to mount it to see that. You can see this like this. If you want to change that logical volume, logical size of that video, you can change it. And if you want to change the physical state of the video, but you have to increase the black device size first, then run this command. You can use grow physical --name equal to video test, so that whatever the black device size is there, that will grow automatically. So this is the command to grow physically. But in order to grow this one, you have to add the space on the black device first, then change that black device, changes whatever the file system you want to make it change, then use this grow, so that it will automatically grow. So if you want to remove that video, then first of all you have to unmount the device forcefully. Okay, then you just give the udev adm setil command and just say dm setup remove and video name here. Okay, then video remove --force or normal --name equal to video test. So the video will be removed. So now if you go to video stats --hu, there is no video. Like this, you can use this video to create the file system or the stuff. So the video is on a black device first, top of that we will create a video. In that video, it's going to be maintain the UDS kernel module, which is creates the deduplication index on the using the kernel module. Top of that, you can create the file systems and use it. That's about it, guys. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Look in the description for this URL of the playlist, and you can see remaining videos of the upgrade to RHEL 8 course. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.